When my grandpa George was a teenager, he built his first car. That's what was happening in the early 1900s in almost all homes around the whole nation. If you wanted a car, you ordered all of the pieces to get sent to you from Detroit, Michigan. They came on a train, you picked up the crate, you went home, you read the instructions, and you put your car together. It didn't matter how old you were or how young you were, if you wanted the car, you had to build it yourself. We don't live in that time anymore. In fact, not only do I not know how to build a car, but there are a lot of other things that I probably couldn't build or fix. I'm not saying every person needs to know how to build their own car. I think it's fine to get them off the lot. But I have noticed there are other adult skills that children just aren't learning very well nowadays. In this video, I'll share 5 ways to teach adult skills, life skills, to young adults so that they end up with adult success and increased confidence. There is a saying that goes like this: without vision, the people perish, which suggests everyone needs to know where they're going, otherwise they never get there. In order to raise young adults who are prepared for the rigors of adult life, we've got to give them a vision of where they need to go. In fact, one of the best skills that young adults can learn is time management and goal setting. Those two go hand in hand. When you set goals, then you usually are going to start managing your time to go along with trying to accomplish those goals. If I set a goal to exercise every day, then I'm going to have to plan when that exercise is going to occur and when I'm going to do the other things that I need to do in the day. So goal setting is huge. Have meetings with your young adult or teen and talk to them about what their plans are for the future. Don't be discouraged if they don't know, and help them not be discouraged if they don't know either. They don't have to know everything, but there are some things that are standard in a person's life when they're growing up, such as employment. What do they need to prepare for employment? Maybe they need to learn a certain skill set. Maybe they need to learn how to fill out an application for a job. Maybe they need to start doing some work for your family business at home so that they prepare to have the skills they need to work for somebody else. They know at some point they'll probably be having employment. Also, there's family relationships, right? We should be setting goals for how we want our family relationships to be. No matter what, you can't just get out of your family. You can try, but they're always there, no matter what. So it might as well be a beautiful part of your life. People have relationships with spouses, with children, with friends, with coworkers. Why not teach them good relationship skills as well? That's going to be a vital thing to set goals for their future happiness. There really isn't anything that gives us more happiness than having love and unity in our relationships. So that's goal setting. Now on to number 2. Number 2 is work. Young adults need to have a good work ethic in order to succeed in adulthood. If a person is too lazy, they're not going to be a success. Employers will put up with a certain amount. Friends will put up with a certain amount of laziness and excuse making. But there really is a lack of respect that develops for a person who always has to have an excuse or take the easy road. It's better to train the children to work hard, which means that you've got to work with them so they know how to do a job and do it well. And your teens or young adults also need lots of opportunities to do projects themselves, where they can problem solve them and come up with systems that work for them to get that work done. The third way to teach young adults life skills is to teach them the skills of self-government. There are 4 basic skills of self-government, which are following instructions, accepting no answers, accepting consequences, and disagreeing appropriately. These 4 basic skills help with all their relationships, their entire lives. They need to know how to accept no answers from friends, from law enforcement, from bosses. They need to be able to follow instructions. When they mess up, they need to know how to fix it, so they've got to accept consequences. A person never learns self-government if all of their problems were always somebody else's fault. They need to take ownership for them themselves. And then they need to learn how to communicate their desires to other people. And we do this with a skill called disagreeing appropriately. They also should learn how to praise other people, how to correct other people, and how to teach other people proper principles and skills as well, because soon they'll be the leader one day, whether in the work environment or in their home environments. So who's going to be showing how to teach and praise and correct and nurture? Parents are. Parents are vital teachers in their children's lives. In fact, they are the ones that the young adults look to for how to solve their relationship problems in the future. Whether they ask you or not, your example will usually be what they follow, even if they didn't want to in the first place. A vital life skill is self-analysis. A person needs to feel that it's safe, comfortable, productive, totally okay to look at themselves and say, I wanted to do really good at waking up on time in the morning, and I'm not. So I've got to fix that problem. Or they might look at themselves and say, you know, I keep speaking sarcastically to all my friends, and I think that could come across as rude. I'm going to change the way that I speak. In order to wake up on time, we have to give ourselves an instruction. In order to stop speaking rude to our friends, we need to give ourselves a no answer. So you see how learning those four basic skills is going to be a key factor in what they're able to analyze about themselves. Self-analysis sets a person free. It opens the door to repentance, changing a path, putting a person in a direction that they planned on going in the first place, but might have strayed from. Self-analysis truly is a life skill that many people never master. If your children decide that it's okay to analyze themselves, and if they can accept what they find and confidently make changes, they will become leaders. Number 5, young adults need to learn how to have a meeting, a productive meeting. In the Teaching Self-Government Parenting Program, we advocate for having regular family meetings. And there's a way to make these meetings productive so that they don't turn into family fights. We talk about that as well. In fact, there are other videos about how to have great family meetings on this channel. So if you subscribe, you won't miss those. Every one of us have been to one of those meetings, whether it's a church meeting, a community meeting, a board meeting. When people in the meeting do not stay on task, they don't actually discuss anything productive, they waste everybody's time with anecdotes and little jokes, and for some reason at the end you go, why did I come to this? That's because those people don't know how to run a really good meeting. My children know how to run a meeting. They know how to keep things on time when they're having a meeting with other people. Everyone needs the skill for how to keep a meeting on track if they're going to be successful in life. In fact, if your young adult or teen is meant to be the leader of other people instead of always just the one following along, then they need to know how to lead the group by keeping everybody united and on task in a meeting. So have family meetings. Have meetings one-on-one with the child. That would have a different format than having a full family meeting. And that way they can learn how to discuss one-on-one with people about issues that matter. And they can also have that communication that you develop when you're in a group, which is slightly different when you're problem solving there. Good communication is a vital life skill for young adults. In everything that we've discussed here about teaching life skills to young adults, we haven't even mentioned social skills, which is a huge one. So next, watch my video called How to Teach Appropriate Social Skills.